So I was there barely into my sophomore year. I was staying at the hostel, but then at the same time, oh, I know what happened. I was staying at the hostel. I told Data that I was living at the hostel, and she said, look, there's a dormitory on this campus. There's a sorority house. I guess I stayed at the sorority house. I went to a sorority house it was a Greek sorority house. The women had rooms renting on the second and third floors. So I think it was second floor, so I went to see them, and then I had two roommates who were not part of the sorority. And I guess that must have been before Christmas. I guess I must have enrolled rather late because I went home with my roommates for Christmas. They lived in this very small town in a place called Tiffin, Ohio, I think. And they had cars. Both of them were married, and their husbands were overseas, and they were going to school. And they invited me to their home in Tiffin, Ohio. So I went, and we had a lovely time with their family and spent Christmas with them. And then when we went back to the sorority house, we were met by a group of sorority sisters on the walk, and they said, you can't come in here, you can't come back in. And then I looked on the porch and I noticed that all my belongings were on the porch, you know, my suitcase, and then a lot of lamps and things like that were kind of loose. And they said that somebody else had moved into my room. And so Becky got the two women that I was with, their names are Miriam and Becky. I just remember. They said, they got very angry. And they said, what do you mean if, and then they said, well, we're not talking about you, just her, you know. And so they said, we couldn't figure, of course, we didn't know what was going on. And they started to argue. And then one of the sorority sisters, this young woman, she just burst into tears, and she said, it's not us, you know, it's the alumni, you know, our sorority sisters alumni who are advisors. They told, when they found out that, you know, that Miss Toya was living in this, they said that we couldn't have a Japanese living in our house, and that we had to ask her to leave. And so then they got very angry, and they said, well, if she has to leave, then we're going to leave too. And which was quite noble, you know, for them. So I went back to the Dean of Women because I recognized that she was quite a good friend, and asked her if there was a place I could live in walking distance to the campus. So then she found the room in the dormitory where I was staying, which was right out, it's a little distance down the hill from the University of Cincinnati. And I stayed, it was a three-story dormitory. They had a few private rooms down on the second floor. The house mother lived on the first floor. And the large room upstairs was what was called a dorm room. And there were eight of us. It was the cheapest room in the dormitory, and so I had seven roommates.